salvation. This is a call for salvation. If you do not know Jesus, this is a call for salvation. Call for salvation. Respond to the call for salvation. If you don't know the Savior, this is his presentation. It's been 2,000 years.
Hello, and welcome to Voices in the Wilderness. I'm Reverend Maria. Jesus said, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven comes near." Repenting means more than just saying that you're sorry for your sins. It means to return back to God and change your way of thinking. Friends, we're living in difficult times. Life as we know it has changed, but God never changes. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. So let today be the day that you draw closer to God. The kingdom of heaven may be nearer than you think. Our scripture of the day is Mark chapter 16, verse 20. They went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word with signs following. Amen. Amen. My guests today are Dan and Sandy Segura. They are two of the New Mexico leaders for Heartland Apostolic Prayer Network, HAPN. One of their prayers and mission is to turn the hearts of America and the nations towards God. They pray for and believe that God will raise up his people to positions of authority so that they can have a positive influence in the areas of business, religion, family, education, government, arts, media, and entertainment. I too believe that we need godly people in these areas for such a time as this. Well, welcome, Dan. Welcome again. Yep. And welcome, Sandy.
Thank you.
And so, Dan, you and I did part one of this interview, and you brought your lovely wife, Sandy.
Thank you.
And so we had such an interesting conversation, right? So, friends, you have to watch part one. You will get nuggets of wisdom, of prayer, of intimacy, of how to pray for your region. And so we're delighted that you're back. And, you know, God is so wonderful. And, you know, the way he works with all of us, right? And he's worked with you in the area of praying, being intercessors for our state. You know, we're here in New Mexico. And you both, well, just if you can recap, what is the main vision, the main goal of your ministry?
Well, it's to cooperate with heaven to see kingdom come and your will be done in New Mexico, to do our part, like we all have a part. We want to see the transformation of New Mexico. New Mexico is last in per capita income, or tied with Mississippi, and just last in a lot of the things that are so important to life, living life, and first in a lot like crimes and drugs and human traffic. There's just bad stuff we're near the front. So we need to see a transformation, and I believe very much we're gonna see an Isaiah 35 transformation as the remnant church presses into the heart of God, to get up on his lap in our in intimacy and put our hearts up against his chest and hear his heart for the issues of society, but not just the issues, the individual, because he cares about each and every person, every individual. So that's what we want to see, is the transformation take place. Amen. As we press into the heart of the Father.
Amen.
And receive the downloads for what he would have. Jesus said that, "I only do what I see the Father do, only say what I hear the Father say." And so he had that communion or co-union, that intimacy. The word koinonia, you're familiar with that word, it's a benediction to the Corinthian letters, the love of God, the love of Jesus, I forget how he says, but the fellowship or communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. That word is koinonia, and it's a Jewish idiom for the intimacy between a husband and a wife. And the word genosko also comes up when he said, they some people will come to Jesus, "Didn't we prophesy in your name? Didn't we heal in your name?" He said, "Depart from me, I never knew you." The word is genosko. Mm-hmm. And it's that intimacy between husband and wife.
Yes.
Mary told Gabriel, the angel, how could these things be about having a child? I don't know genosko, man. I've not known. Mm-hmm. She's not in the marital relationship. So that intimacy is key, and from that will come the transformation that we want to see.
Amen.
As we press into the heart of the Father.
Amen. And I think he's working for that for such a time as this, with all of us, for, yes, with the church, to get closer to God, to learn, to be prepared, mm-hmm, for the things that are happening. And you know, His scripture says that in the last days, God's going to pour out His Spirit on all flesh, mm-hmm, and His sons and daughters will prophesy. Yep. His old men will dream dreams, young men will have visions. Mm-hmm. And so I see an increase in this, in these prophetic giftings, right? Yes. And so I know that the Lord speaks to you through your dreams, and you know, not that you're old, because He's...
But I am. I can stay with the vision. So.
Because He gives us all dreams and visions and His Spirit, right. So this is for all of us. And so I know, too, Sandy, that the Lord has gifted you with the the prophetic, right? Mm-hmm. So I wanted to ask you about this, because a lot of the churches or people, you know, we have no problem with teaching, we have no problem with evangelism, right, but when it comes to, let's say, the apostolic or, you know, and the prophetic, it's like, oh, that's not for today. But if we believe that these are this last days, then right, it has to be for today.
Correct.
Because we see an increase in this.
That's right.
So talk about that. What is the prophetic? What does that mean?
The prophetic is God's way of speaking to a person so that that person can relay what God is saying to them to someone who has need of a word or a need of edifying or lifting up, someone who may be struggling, someone who is seeking an answer, is looking for an answer. And so God will speak to me in pictures and visions. And in doing so, and it took me a while, because I was told that I had a prophetic gifting. And when someone tells you something like that, your first impression is, me?
Right.
You know, wait a minute, that's biblical, I understand that, but for you to be the one. And so when we first started, someone spoke this over me, and they even prophesied over both of us. It took me a while to understand what that meant, and it meant asking God, Father, if this is something for me, what is it that I have to do? What is it I have to say? And seeking for Him to speak to my heart. Because in prayer, you talk to God all the time. Mm-hmm. And even some of us talk to God all the time, but never hear Him or never listen for an answer.
Right.
Well, I had to learn that when He was speaking and when it was me speaking.
Right.
And so as a result, it would be something completely out of the blue. Something that I wouldn't even be thinking at that moment would just come to me. Mm. And it was even when Dan and I were working in a healing class, we would be walking around the sanctuary praying, and it wasn't until the head of my household would ask me, is God saying anything to you? Before I would ask Him, oh, Father, you know, besides talking to you, I need to know if there's something that you have for me to say, mm-hmm, or for me to...
And the revelation often was a word of knowledge, but it, mm-hmm, would, yeah, manifest it in a physical sensation. Physical. For example, someone was going to be in the class that had pain in their jaw. Mm-hmm. She would get a pain in the jaw, or if, yeah, there was intestinal things, she'd feel a sensation then.
But it wasn't until I asked.
Right.
And then I would, and not always something would come, but there were periodic times when, yes, I would get a sensation, and sometimes more than one. And I had to enumerate in my mind and heart, you know, okay, first there's this, and then there's this. And until I told Him, or we prayed over that person, the sensation would remain. Once we prayed, it was gone.
Wow, that's interesting. So I was wondering, like, in biblical times, when the prophet came to town, I mean, he came to give a word, to warn them,
right,
you know, to rebuke them, you know, to warn them of punishment if they continued,
right,
in their evil ways. And so, I mean, people used to shake, let's say,
yeah,
when the prophet came to town.
Right.
Do you think that people today see the prophet the same as they did in biblical times?
Well, I think you can explain it better than me, but there's the office of a prophet, and then there's the gift of prophecy. And I have the gift. The prophet is someone whose word is its law. I know God reveals things to me for a reason, and I would give the word to that person for that reason that is needed at that moment in time. I don't operate on a regular basis because my lifestyle is not such where I can spend more time, mm-hmm, speaking to God and that kind of thing. But I don't think that today the prophet is seen at, like Elijah.
Right.
Elijah was, you know, he walked into a place and everyone shook, I'm sure.
Right.
They were fearful of what he might have to say, or those who were calling, you know, stopping the rain.
That's right.
That
That's
kind
right.
of thing. And the way he operated was incredible. I mean, to be able to outrun, what was it that he was outrunning the Ethiopian to get to that
Ahab.
Point?
Ahab.
Ahab.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The chariot.
Right. The chariot. And so, you know, he operated in a realm totally different from what I'm used to, but no, I don't think
well,
they
Well, there's
see.
A difference between the Old Testament prophet and the
New Testament
prophet.
Yeah.
The New Testament, the purpose of prophecy, 1 Corinthians 14, is edification, exhortation, comfort.
Right.
Well,
right.
oftentimes when the prophet came to town in the Old Testament, it wasn't necessarily
no
edification.
Or comfort,
yeah.
right?
It was a different ministry.
Right.
But now we still have prophets, but they operate under that job responsibility,
right,
is
right.
edification, extra,
right.
and comfort. Hebrews 1 talks about in biblical times, the Old Testament, God spoke many times through the prophet, yes. but in these last days, he has spoken through his son, Hebrews 1 says. Well, the son is a filter. Everything
right.
filters through the son, and
right.
it's a heart of compassion, of love.
Right.
He's the personification of the heart of the Father.
Right.
And so it's not the same as the prophet coming down and everyone's shaking, and they're just, it's edification,
yeah.
exhortation, and comfort.
Although I think that there are some, probably, that do have that I'm thinking of Jonathan Kahn,
right.
that you know, you really kind of listen to him when he's speaking with his prophetic words. But you're right. I think the Lord gives all of us a different kind of gifting, a level of gifting,
exactly.
whatever. But, you know, it's like these gifts that we have, they're not for us. They're to share.
Exactly.
And I think that it's so beautiful what you're doing, because when, you know, this is a time that people need comforting.
Yeah.
They need that reassurance, mm-hmm. because we are in such dark times.
That's
so
true.
So I think when the Lord uses you to go and lift up a person and comfort them,
right.
you know, and like you were saying too during the break, that sometimes he'll give you a word or whatever, and you don't even know what it is, but you may share it with the person,
correct.
And then they know exactly,
right.
you know, what that is, and that ministers to them so much. And I know that it's happened, you know, and I've seen it, and where it's like, oh my goodness, you just spoke a word to me,
right.
And so I think that comes from
be a confirmation.
A confirmation.
Yeah.
So that really comes from that connection you have with the Holy Spirit. And these are the times that I think he's training all of us,
yes.
to understand how to be trained up in the Holy Spirit.
Galatians 5:25 says, if we live by the Spirit, let us walk in step with the Spirit.
Yeah.
So we live by the Spirit, because we're John 3, unless you're born of the Spirit, you can't enter the kingdom of. And then we walk in step. That's day to day, one step in front of another. In other words, the day to day stuff, the second by second, minute by minute,
right.
in sync, led of Holy Spirit, because he's got the master plan,
right.
and he takes to the Father. Eye has not seen, and the natural ears not heard, but the Spirit reveals those things, because he searches the deep things of God and brings them to us. John 16, Jesus talked about Holy Spirit revealing those things to us. So we need to press into the heart of the Father, get
yes.
Holy Spirit direction
yes.
and leading, so that we can do the things that Jesus did, and even greater things, because he went to the Father, sent Holy Spirit.
Right.
We can't miss that way. But
right.
if we go off on our own, we can get in trouble. We could
yes.
even get in physical problems, you know, if we go out doing some assignments on the land and
That's
stuff.
That's right. Right.
We can get in trouble, because
right.
he didn't necessarily
didn't
send
say,
us out. We
right.
took it upon ourselves in presumption.
Yes.
And that's a mistake.
And we see that too when we run away from his, like in Jonah, you know, if you run away, there's consequences.
Right. There's a whale out there.
There's a whale out there. So we do have to be in tune to what the Holy Spirit is telling
well,
us.
Well, I also think that it's important that we remain that childlike faith.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Because when someone tells you that you have a prophetic gifting or whatever gifting that they have prophesied over you, you kind of right away, you know, me? Why me?
Right.
And how am I going to know it's God talking, that kind of thing.
Right.
And I think it's because people are afraid that they would get it wrong, because we being human, we sometimes,
right.
you know, put our human side in there instead of our spiritual side.
Right.
And so it took some time and some effort on my part to understand it was God speaking to me,
mm-hmm.
To step out in faith and say what needed to be said.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't step out and try, it's just like There's a gentleman by the name of Joaquin Evans at Bethel Church and Bill Johnson's church. Mm-hmm. And he said when they first started going out and taking a team of youth to go out and pray for people for healing, mm-hmm. Nothing would happen. And then maybe one time a healing would take place. But as they went out more and more and they honed their gift as God had given them to pray for people,
right. There
was more healings. And it got to a point where they were expecting healings all the time. And then if it didn't happen, they were surprised because it didn't happen. And so it's the same with us, knowing that God is speaking to our hearts, telling us what we have, and to war for that prophetic word, as it says, it's 1 Timothy 1:18. For us to war for that gifting, because if we don't take it and keep talking it to, Lord, you said mm-hmm. about this, about me, and hold on to it. Mm-hmm. I think there's an article that you wrote in the Bible about a gentleman who was in Georgia who was supposed to be in, he was supposed to be in office, some kind of office, a mm-hmm. senator or something like that. And I can't remember the prophet that spoke over him, the guy that just passed away recently with long hair, the musician.
Kim Clement
mm-hmm. prophesied over him because he was a realtor at the time. And he said he was going to become a politician. Mm-hmm. Well, the man had a major heart attack and he died. And he was dead at the scene, dead on the way to the ambulance, and he was dead at the hospital. Well, his wife held on to that prophetic word mm-hmm. that was spoken over him, and she went in and she put her hands on him. He's dead, mm-hmm. and she's speaking to him and telling him, "You have not done what was prophesied over you. You are going to be a political man. Your son is going to follow after you, who is an adopted son." And she held on to that, and they had to take her out of there because she was just going to town, you know. And they called security to take her out. But before she left this dead body, the life came back into him.
Yeah.
But he remained in a coma state. Wow. And then she went and prayed for him again, because she wanted him to come out, because the doctors were telling her, well, he's going to remain in a coma forever, and his brain cells have been mm-hmm. damaged and all that. And so she went and prayed again, and he came right to, and he spoke his son's name. And so she held on to that. She warred for that prophetic. And I think we need to have that faith.
That faith, yes. A faith and a peace that passes all understanding.
Correct.
That faith. And that's, you know, the Lord, He wants us to have that faith, yeah. so that we can fulfill our destiny, because too many people are so ready to give up. Oh, it didn't happen once, let's give up. Right. But yes, we have to press in.
Yes.
And you were saying about, you know, it's a process. You know,
even in
biblical times, they had school of the prophets. So you had to learn, they had
right.
to, this is something that's developed. Yes, the Lord gives us a gift, but if you're not practicing your gift, it's like anything else.
Right.
It's like practicing our faith, you know, practicing the presence of God, you know, that we need to always be having our eyes on Jesus.
Correct.
And growing in whatever it is that
well,
it is given us.
That's part of the transformation that
yes.
we look to participate in is helping people, first of all, recognize that they're gifted, because all carry gifts. The gifts and the calling of God are without
right.
repentance. So there's unsaved people going around utilizing their gifts. Some are psychics, but they're using the gift that God gave them in
yeah,
an illegal
right.
way. So we want to be help people train up the way Sandy trained up. We got trained in at Christian International through the Hammond mm-hmm. people, Bill Hammond.
Getting books and everything mm-hmm. on who.
And then practicing in a safe
yeah.
environment. You know, we did that at Glory Bound in the environment of the church. Mm-hmm. If we get it wrong, that's okay. It's very safe. But after we start learning how to cooperate with Holy Spirit, hear the voice of Holy Spirit, mm-hmm. then when we go out in the field,
right.
then
right.
it's not so new.
Right, right, right. Mm-hmm. And you know, it is wonderful, you know, to get a prophetic word. But, you know, we know that the best prophetic words come from Himself. So we individuals have to spend time
mm-hmm.
with God, because
Amen.
A lot of times, you know, people are depending, oh, the prophet's going to come to town this month at this meeting,
right.
but their lives don't change.
Right.
So that's kind of something that we have to be concerned about, to encourage them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you seek God for yourself. You know, you want to know your destiny? Open
exactly.
your Bible. It's right there, you know.
He even said that, my sheep know my voice. Yes. My sheep hear my voice. So if I believe with all my heart that we all hear his voice, but a lot of us don't recognize that it's him, so we don't know his voice. And that might be through an impression, an idea, a picture, a dream, a vision, a thought that comes to mind. And sometimes we think, where did that come from? Or is that me? Or what is that? Right. But oftentimes it's God speaking to us. Right. And so we need to press into that. And we need to pray into that, come into agreement. And Jesus addressed that in John 17 when he's praying to the Father. John 17 is all about the prayer the Father. John 17, 6, he said, told the Father, the words that you've given me, I've given them. That is logos.
Right.
But two verses later, he says the same thing again, only this time it's rhema. It's revelation. It's the logos being activated for our circumstance right here, right now, in the very thing that you're facing. Holy Spirit is illuminating the logos into a rhema word as to what you're to do. Because the prophetic word is not to tell you what you're supposed to be doing necessarily, it's supposed to activate you and help you wake up, awaken to who you really are, who you were destined to be.
Right.
There is an identity we have to live. There's a destiny. Mm-hmm. There's a calling we have. There's a purpose for our lives.
Right.
The purpose is the why. The destiny is the what, where we're to be. Mm-hmm. The calling is like a summons. It is a like we get a call on the phone. We're being invited to a conversation. That's what God is doing with the calling.
Yeah.
So we need to get to that destiny that God has for us, and it has to do with pressing into the heart of the Father and hearing what the Father says.
Yes, and that's the main thing, is just having that intimate relationship with God, so that he can reveal what our divine destiny is. You know, I like that that scripture that says, don't be conformed with the patterns of the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you will know the good, acceptable, and perfect will of God.
Right.
So, I think, like, if people don't know what the good, acceptable, that's simply because their minds haven't been transformed to the degree that God wants them to know the good, the acceptable, and perfect will of
God. And that's a progression, too.
And that's a progression.
The good, the perfect, the perfect will of God.
Well,
and they've been so inundated with the way we have been thinking through all the generations. We've not been thinking, like when I was in church as a little girl in the Catholic Church, I remember being in awe, thinking I seeing halos on everybody at the altar, you know, that kind of thing. I had a reverence for God then. Mm-hmm. And if you look back in your childhood, hopefully your childhood was blessed as mine was, God spoke to us at some time in our life.
Yes.
I believe a lot of children get spoken to. And so if we look to that time and moment in time and remember that he was communicating then, and you were communicating at the same time as a child, innocent, then it can happen for you today, no matter what your life has been like, no matter what your past might have been, if it was a past that you don't want to be, you know, involved in any longer, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. He loves us so much that he wants us to have that relationship, a one-on-one, not what anybody else thinks of you, not what anybody else tells you, but you and he. And when I came to having a saving knowledge of what Jesus did for me, it wasn't anybody influencing me, it was Holy Spirit himself, because Dan, bless his heart, was already serving the Lord, and he went and told everyone. And I don't want anyone to get discouraged about people who are not saved, that are in their families, even though they're saved, because if you keep praying for them, you keep interceding for them. And he was telling everyone, my wife's not saved, pray for her, my wife's not saved. And he never said a word to me. No one told me anything, but the Holy Spirit started convicting me in my heart. And I don't want people to get discouraged and say, this relationship is not for me.
Right.
I don't live like that. It's not my life.
Right.
I want them to know that it is and can be their life. And it's only because he created them with a purpose.
Yes.
And they have no reason not to believe that, except for life might have taken them another path. But they need to know that he had a path for them.
Amen.
And they need to come back to that path. And if they do, they will be so utterly blessed beyond belief.
Thank you for saying that, because I think that there are a lot of husbands and wives that have been waiting for that, for their spouses to come and be of the same mind, of the same spirit.
Right.
And so thank you, because, I mean, how can you give up on your a beloved husband, yeah. beloved wife. You can't. Yeah. You want them to serve the Lord because God has promised us eternity.
That's right.
And we want to know that they will be eternally with the Father.
Exactly.
And so I know that you both, of course, back to your wonderful commission, your wonderful assignment that you have to praying for our state.
Yes.
What is the vision for New Mexico? I wanted to ask you, in our other show, in our first show, because I think it's important that we hear, what is the vision that you see for
our vision is spelled out in Isaiah 35, and I would encourage people to pray for that for New Mexico. Our vision is to help people activating their gifting. Ultimately, to be able to interact with people throughout New Mexico as God provides the means, the finances, which are coming, they are coming, to engage with people on a one-to-one level, on a group level, and to do our part to strengthen marriages, to address issues of the day, such as drug addiction,
yes.
Sex trafficking, per capita income. There's a lot. My background is business. And there's a lot that I feel the Lord is going to have us do regarding the economy,
yes.
and it's going to ultimately, if the bottom line is the soul, is people coming to Christ, but it's going to bless them because one thing that has to happen is the kingdom has tangible, measurable results
yes.
in the natural,
yes.
and that's going to manifest in every aspect of society because that's the heart of the Father.
And that's the way in the Old Testament was that they're blessed. The Lord promises blessings
yes.
when we're obedient,
right.
when we walk with Him,
Amen.
You know, and not only that, but when we're obedient and walking with Him, He gives us that wisdom to know how to conduct our business,
Amen.
To know how to be good parents.
Amen.
Wisdom is so important. I know for this is January, right? And for the last few years, I don't know how 5 years, whatever. I encourage people to take one chapter a day of the Proverbs,
right?
Right? 31 days, 31 chapters of Proverbs,
mm-hmm.
so that they could understand. Because you want to know about relationships, you want to know about finances. Go to the Word. I mean, that is wonderful mm-hmm. information, holy information.
Amen.
So praise God for that.
Yes.
You know,
I love Proverbs. I spend every day a chapter a day in Proverbs,
yes.
a chapter in Psalms, a chapter in New Testament, a chapter in the
yes.
Old, and the Proverbs in Passion is especially good.
You know, our time's up.
Yeah.
It goes so fast,
it does,
right?
Yeah.
So thank you so much for being here.
Thank
and
you for having
thank
us.
You so much, our viewing audience, for joining us. If you'd like more information about my program, please contact me at mariagoldstein7@gmail.com. Check out my website, www.voicesinthewildernesstv. Until next time, we wish you good health, success, and spiritual growth. God loves you so much, and so do we. Take care.
Call for salvation. This is a call for salvation. If you do not know Jesus, this is a call for salvation. A call for salvation. Respond to the call.
Who hath ascended up into heaven or descended? Who hath gathered the wind in his fists? Who hath bound the waters in a garment? Who hath established all the ends of the earth? What is his name? And what is his son's name, if thou canst tell? Proverbs 34. The mystery of the Hebrew letters, Jesus Revealed, by Reverend Dr. Maria Goldstein, is available now in bookstores everywhere.